What is the other possibility of alternative MRI signals between diffusion weighted image and ADC maps rather than restricted diffusion? Good day everyone, I'm Dr. Usam Ibrahim from Easy and Different Radiology, and this is my talk for MRI learning today, which is representing step 11 from MRI learning. So let's get started. As we talked before about restricted diffusions in the previous two presentations and the causes of the restricted diffusions, and to diagnose the restricted diffusions, you should have high diffusion weighted image MRI signal and low ADC map. But in this presentation, in the current presentations, I will talk for other possibilities between the diffusion weighted image and the ADC map in Z signal. So the learning objective for my presentation today is talking about the other possibilities of alternative signals between diffusion weighted image and ADC map rather than restricted diffusion, and also what is the MRI expressions for each one and what is the clinical significance from these alternative signals. Restricted diffusion, T2 shine through, fluid, T2 blackout, T2 washout. This is the clinical expressions for alternative signal MRI between diffusion weighted image and ADC. In the diffusion weighted image, if it is high and the ADC is low, it considers as a restricted diffusion. However, if the diffusion weighted image is high and the ADC also high, so this is which is called the T2 shine through. If diffusion weighted image is low and the ADC is high, this is considered as a fluid, as CSF fluids in the ventricles or central necrosis or arachnoid cyst fluid. This is appeared as low signal in diffusion weighted image, high signal in ADC. The other possibility is the diffusion weighted image appeared low and the ADC appeared low also, and this is which is called the T2 blackout. If the diffusion weighted image signal appeared ISO, intense signal, and the ADC appeared high, so this is represented by T2 washout, which represent for edema. So this is the alternative signals between diffusion weighted image ADC, and this is the clinical expressions for this signal, and what is the representing of each one, we'll see and discuss it in the next cases. So let us enjoy with radiology with these next five cases with different alternative signals between diffusion weighted image and ADC, and we'll see how can express for that and what is the clinical significance for this expression. Every case we should detect where is the diffusion weighted image and the ADC map from the different MRI sequence, and then describe the signal within these specific two MRI sequences if it is high or low, and then what is the clinical significance or expressions for this when the you detect the signal in each MRI sequence. So let's start. Case one is a 45-year-old female with seizure, and this is a different MRI sequence. To answer the first questions, you should detect the ADC and diffusion weighted image. This is a diffusion weighted image, which appears CSF low signal, and the white matter is darker than the gray matter, and also the image appeared slightly hazy. And this is the abnormal signal, which is high signal in the left parietal lobe. And the ADC, this is the ADC, which is showing the CSF is bright and appeared as a map, so it is called ADC map. And the lesions appeared also high signal in the same regions of the diffusion weighted image, which have high signal. When the diffusion and the ADC are high, both are high, what is the clinical expression for that? This is which is called the T2 shine through. And the other sequence is this T2 weighted image. CSF appeared bright and white matter appeared slightly darker than the gray matter. And this is a T1 weighted image, as the white matter is brighter than the gray matter. And this case diagnosed as anaplastic astrocytoma. The lesson today is to how to describe the T2 shine through and how can detect it from the diffusion weighted image and ADC. Again, next case, the same, detect the sequence and detect the signal within the sequence and also describe its scientific expression, MRI scientific expression. The next case is a 45-year-old female with hypertension and seizure. Where is the diffusion weighted image? This one is a diffusion weighted image sequence. And where is the ADC? This one is the ADC. The signal appeared high signal in ADC in the occipital loop bilateral and also appeared ISO signal in the diffusion weighted image or slightly high but not high signal like ADC. ADC is higher than in the signal in the from the diffusion weighted image. So when it is ISO in diffusion and high in ADC, it's called the T2 washout. T2 washout signal representing edema, and this is confirmed by the FLIR MRI sequence, which appeared also high in the posterior occipital loop. And this is a high diffusion weighted image as a B0 value, which also appeared a high signal. From the history and locations of the lesions and the edema characters due to T2 washout, the diagnosis of PRESS is highly suggestive in this case, and it is diagnosed and confirmed as a PRESS, posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome. Next case to detect the signal and abnormal the sequence and abnormal signal, and also what is the clinical expressions for this signal. This was a case of male patient, 62 years old, and has a history of adenocarcinoma in the lung. And these are lesions appeared here. Where is the diffusion weighted image sequence first? This one is a diffusion weighted image, and the lesions appeared low signal in diffusion. And where is the ADC? This is the ADC, and also the lesions appeared low signal in ADC. Low signal in both. So what is the scientific MRI expressions for these low signals in both diffusion and the ADC? Is the T2 blackout. What is the representing T2 blackout clinically? Representing hematoma. If we look at the surrounding tissues of the lesions, it appeared high signal in the ADC and iso-intense signal in the diffusion weighted image, which also representing a T2 washout, which representing edema. So we have a hematoma surrounding by an edema. However, due to the history of the patient of adenocarcinoma of the lung, we should consider metastasis. The other sequence can helping for this diagnosis, as this sequence of contrast enhancing lesions and the lesions appeared enhancing. So hematoma which enhance in the post contrast or post gadolinium study representing metastasis, and this was diagnosed as a hemorrhagic lung cancer metastasis. The lesson from MRI learning today is how to discriminate the T2 washout from surrounding edema and how can describe T2 blackout from the low signal in both low ADC and low diffusion weighted image MRI sequence. Fourth case, the same questions. for that case of 72 years old female and have history of visual disturbance. Start to detect the diffusion weighted image sequence and the ADC. Actually, this is a diffusion weighted image sequence and have high signal. There are lesions in the midline here and have high signal diffusion, which appeared in the ADC with low signal. High signal diffusion and low signal in ADC, this is representing restricted diffusion. However, other sequence showing enhancement of the lesion, and this enhancement is homogeneous enhancement and also appearing isointense in T2. Homogeneous enhancing lesions with restricted diffusions is representing highly cellularity lesions or high cytoplasmic concentration, and this also surrounding by tissue which have high signal in the ADC and also isointense signal in the diffusions, and this MRI clinical expressions is called T2 washout, which representing clinically by edema. And this is confirmed also here in the T2, which is showing edema as high signal surrounding the lesion. And this lesion was a benign, diagnosed as a benign meningioma due to homogeneous enhancement and restricted diffusion also. Now the last case, 69-year-old female with left side weakness. We should detect the diffusion weighted image and the ADC and the signals of both, and also what is the clinical expression according to the signal. Actually, I will talk here about this area which have a arrowhead, and this area appeared in the diffusion weighted image as a low signal and appeared in the ADC map as a high signal, and this is considered a central necrosis. Central necrosis due to signal in the diffusions is similar to CSF in the ventricle, and also signal in ADC map similar to the CSF, so it considered as a fluid, and this fluid is shown within lesions mass, and so it is considered as a central necrosis. However, the tumor tissue itself appeared high signal in diffusion and low signal in ADC map, which representing as a restricted diffusion. And the surrounding tissue appeared high signal in ADC and isointense signal in the diffusion weighted image. So this is which is called the T2 washout. T2 washout representing edema, which is shown clearly here in this flare image. And also the lesions appeared heterogeneous enhancing with central area of non-enhancing, which representing necrosis. And also this is a CT examination of the patient, which is showing lesions which appeared heterogeneous signal or density in unenhanced CT. This was a case of the glioblastoma multiformis. And in this case, the lesson here is central necrosis, which appearing low signal in the diffusion weighted image and high signal in the ADC. Now to summarize my presentation, we have a lot of signal between the diffusion and the ADC map, and according to these signals, whether it's high or low, we can describe clinical expressions in MRI which representing clinically for some disease or pathology like necrosis or edema or restricted diffusions or like this. So I make these schedules to facilitate remembering the T2 Chinese row, a T2 washout, T2 blackout, restricted diffusion and the fluid. This is the MRI expressions when the diffusion weighted image is high and the ADC is high also. It's called the T2 chain through, but diffusion weighted image is slightly higher than in signal than ADC. However, if both are high or the diffusion weighted image is iso-intense signal or lower in the signal than the ADC, slightly lower than it, so it is called T2 washout, which occurring with breath or representing edema. However, if both diffusion weighted image and ADC are low signal, it representing a T2 blackout, which occurring with the hematoma. We're talking a lot about the restricted diffusions, which have high signal in diffusion weighted image and low signal in ADC. And the fluids, don't forget, it have a signal similar to the CSF, low signal in diffusion and high signal in ADC map. And this is occurring with central necrosis, for example, or with any fluids like arachnoid cyst or CSF in the ventricle. Thank you very much for your watching, and wait me every Wednesday for MRI learning lesson, every Sunday for rapid review anatomy, and every Friday for Arabic presentations or mnemonic words. And also, you can watch more than 60 presentations in my YouTube channels by searching in the Google search by Easy and Different Radiology. This is the name of my channel. Thank you for your watching, and have a nice time.